Here's four beautiful catfish fillets, never frozen, from HEB. They're farm raised, I'm sure. But anyway, we're gonna cut them in smaller pieces so that they'll fry faster. And what I'm gonna do is cut them at an angle. So let's go like this. Throw it over there. Manageable sizes, starting with where the ribs were cut out. See, that's a big chunk, but it's manageable. Manageable for who? That's good. Same with this one. The smaller ones you don't have to cut three times, it's two. This paper's cut to shreds, so we'll throw it away afterwards. It's just the paper that it came from HEB. All right. There we have it. Nice pile with paper on them. Some of them, no, that's just the only one. All right, we got that, we got the shrimp. So now we're gonna use these products here and start getting it ready. All right, got ice water here, we got the fish here. We're just gonna put these in there for now, in the ice water. You'll see why here in a sec. Put them up in there. Don't worry about it. Put them in there and get rid of this. All right, now on here, this is your easy cooking directions. First, rinse fish well in ice water. Shake off excess water. Coat the fish in seafood breading. Deep fry at 350 until internal temperature is 145 Fahrenheit and until it's golden brown. Now that right there is a trip, because how do you know the internal temperature if it's in the oil deep frying? You got to actually pull it out, I guess, and stick the probe in it. I've never done that. I've just gone by the color. So we'll see. As long as your oil's 350, you'll know when it's ready. Alrighty. Well, we have our oil at 350. I checked it with the thermopin. I'm using peanut oil in this stab cocotte. So we'll take the fish, shake them, shake it off, drop them in, shake it off, drop it in. Oh, don't shake it so hard that you get water in there. I just did that. That's why it got a little mad there. We do not want that. That could spell trouble in River City. You hear it? No bueno. We'll get that stopping here in a sec. Just get them coated on both sides. Okay. Make sure it's everywhere in the cracks and crevices and all that good stuff. All right. Put them in there. That'll shut that thing up. 350 is the best temperature. And don't overcrowd them. You can just put three for now. There we go. Take a look at some. Just pull one up and kind of look at it. See? It's there, but it's not golden brown. And for grins and giggles, I know I never do this, but let's just see. Look, I'm gonna stick this in there. Says it's ready. I don't get that, man, but can't argue with the thermometer, right? I don't want to overcook them either. I've never probed them, but I guess I should. Let's turn this down a little bit. There's two of them. What I'm going to do, I'm going to set them up here on this, look, and here, and let it drain into a paper towel. Yeah, they look ready. Let me do the rest and we'll start on the shrimps. All right, this is a little different this time. You're gonna take this and get you 5 tablespoons. Put it in a cup, a half a cup of water. Okay, do it the best you can. Ain't gotta be perfect, but it makes a big difference. That's good. All right, just stir it up. Get this back to normal. Stir this up. Make a mess while you're at it. Please do, please do. That'll make me happy. All right, get your shrimps. Just drop them in. Don't worry about it. Drop them in. Put in a, I don't know, manageable amount, because shrimp's smaller than fish, so we can pack them in. Just soak them up in there. Keep going. Shake them a little bit, get that regular water off. Load it up. All right, that's good. Then just get them under there and kind of get it all to know each other. And then we'll carry on. Now we got our shrimp soaked in this slurry mix. Drop them in here. Shake them a little bit off. Just a little bit, don't worry. Drop them up in there. Don't overcrowd it as usual. You can get them up in there, about as many as you want. And then you gotta shake it like it's hot. You don't have to do this, I'm just doing this. You can actually just kinda move them around up in there with a spoon or whatever. Okay, and then start getting your oil hot back up to 350. And we'll carry on. And make a mess too, don't worry. Clean up as you go. Okay, we got our oil back up. Grab these by the tail, see? Get you about 4 or 5. Let's just do 4. Put them in batches. By the tails, see? Better. Batches. They're not a batter, so they shouldn't stick together. These cook fast, remember. These cook very fast. If you overcook a shrimp, you're gonna screw it up. So just give these a few minutes only. See? You don't want to overcook them. You're better to undercook them. Let me just get these going, do the rest, and we'll be ready to taste test some of this with that Ship Ahoy tartar sauce that I made. All right, here's our catfish. That's only 4 fillets, but look how much it came out to. And then we got our shrimp. That's a lot of shrimp for 2 Texans. And then, as a bonus, we got some onion rings. How about that, folks? And of course, we have to thank the friends at Louisiana Fish Fry Products out of Baton Rouge. Probably JB's friends. Anyway, here's the tartar sauce I made yesterday. So let me plate this up and we'll start testing like I haven't already. All right, check it out. Yum. We must start off with what we cooked first, the catfish. So let's take the catfish, dip it up in this tartar sauce I made, Ship Ahoy tartar sauce. If you want the recipe, it's on a previous video. Here we go. Not even funny. Wow. That's this one. Hold on. That's this one. You talk about good, man. It's cheaper to buy it like this than to buy all the spices. And it's good every time. Just follow directions. Shrimp. Dip it. I don't have any shrimp cocktails, so we're gonna go with the tartar sauce again. Mmm. Fall off the shell. So good, man. You don't need to cook them too much. Squeeze the tail and get that little piece out. Wow. Oh man, this is good, folks. So good. I've made it lots of times, but I haven't, and HEB had the shrimp on sale. And I said, well, guess what? I even put some tartar sauce on an onion ring. Why not? Mmm. These are good. This is at Nathan's brand. And they come frozen and at HEB by the French fries. So let me finish this. It's so good. Mmm. That is an onion ring. Anyway, here's the two products I used. You can get them at HEB if you live in Texas. If not, you need to go to www.louisianafishfry.com if you want to order it online. But I bought this and I'm glad I did. And also, believe it or not, if you don't use that much of it, you can put it in a baggie and freeze it. It's not going to hurt anything. In these trying times, that's a good idea. We need to stay frugal instead of just throwing food away. All right? But it's up to you. I'm just saying what I'm going to do. There's no fish in there. There's no shrimp, little pieces or nothing that's going to start smelling or nothing like that. So why waste it? That's my theory. Get you some, folks. Get you some. All right. Well, we're done. That's how you use Louisiana fish fry shrimp and fish products. Very simple, very delicious. Anybody could do this, honestly. Now the peanut oil, that's a little expensive, but it's not that bad. And I'm gonna keep it. I'm gonna strain it out, get all the pieces out, and just keep it for the next cook. It's not destroyed, nothing like that. You know what I mean? All right, well, thanks for watching. We'll see you around. God bless you and adios, amigos. Hey, thanks for stopping by. I appreciate it. If you like the content here, go ahead and subscribe, all right? Because we'll be having a lot more videos coming up in the future. So thanks again. Tell all your friends and we'll see you next time.